Yeah, welcome back to the tutor. We are still doing our Maths 3, as you can see. So today we are going to do our shell method because it's not a deep method when solving the volume of a revolution. And then we are going to introduce our double integration already so that we can make it in one video. And then our last video, we're gonna finish with our test one preparation. Okay, so what do we have to note about shell method? It's all about we have two axes, as we said. Our body is going to rotate in the two axes, which means the x axis and as well our y axis. So let's say, for instance, we have, this is going to be our revolution. This is our coordinate. So you have your x and then you have your y there. Okay, let's say we have a specific body, which is like this, okay? And then they say this body is rotating on the x axis. So we have a rotation in the x axis, okay? But when solving our shell method, the volume of this body is gonna be given by 2 pi of y1, y2, okay? And then x, y ddx, okay? But here's something that you need to note. But when it happened to shell method, the revolution of this body, the revolution of this body is going to involve our formula. We're gonna expect a body that's gonna be revolved on the y-axis so that you can apply this formula, okay? So what you need to write down is that if my body is rotating on the x-axis, okay, but the revolution of this body must be here, which means I need to have a body that will be revolve to the y axis. Therefore I can apply my formula for the volume in the x axis. Can you see? So it's all about you need to check the graphic you draw the revolution of that body. You see that if the body it revolves on the y axis and it's rotating on the x axis, then you can apply your shell method. In the case where the body is still on the x axis, it revolves on the x axis and it's rotating on the x axis, which means you cannot apply your shell method. You are going to apply your disk method. Okay, so we want to have a look on as well on when this body now it's rotating on the y axis. So we have our y axis. This is our y axis. Okay, so we have our y axis. We have something like this, our coordinate x and y. Okay, but now in the problem they say that the body is rotating on the y axis. Okay, so in order for me to apply shell method, I need to make sure that the revolution of my body should be on the x axis. Okay, so that when you apply your volume, it's all gonna be about 2 pi x2 x1 xy ddy. Get a point? This body must be revolved in the x axis while it's rotating on the y axis so that you can apply your disk method. So you can see that with a shell method, it's all about to check the revolution of this body. Okay, so what you are going to write now is that if my body is rotating on the y axis, but this body must be revolved, which means our function of x must be revolved on the x axis. Okay, but in the case when this body it's now on the y axis, can you see? Which means it's rotating on the y axis and our function also is on the y axis. You cannot apply shell method. Now you have to apply your disk method. So we're gonna try to understand this where we're gonna be doing some example under your tutorial. Let's have a look on this question under your tutorial question 6.4. Okay, so you want to see what's going to happen. So we'll try to apply our shell method. But the first thing when you are doing our shell method, we need to draw this function. Therefore, we're going to come here. We put our x and as well y coordinates, you can see that we have y is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0 is going to be where? Somewhere there. So we can say we have a y is equal to 0. Okay? And then we have x is equal to 5. Then you're going to come here, you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then you say x is equal to 5. Okay? So you have a function. Let's say on this function, when x is equal to 0, you can see that y is going to be equal to how much? To 0. So which means if you have y is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, y is going to be equal to 0 as well. Then we say, what happens when x is equal to 1? Then we're going to have y is going to be equal to 2, 1 squared. So y is going to be equal to 2. So when x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2. So when x now is equal to 2, what happened? Y is going to be equal to 2, 2 squared, then we're going to have 8. Can you see? So you can see that this function is exponential, which means the function will be increasing like this because it's exponential. Already we notice that this will be our function. Can you see that? So once we notice what is our function, now we can see that they say this body is rotating on the x-axis. Can you see that? Then you come here, say it's rotating on the y-axis. Okay? But we need to check. In order for us to apply shell methods on the x-axis, we say if my rotation is on the x-axis, the function must be revolved in the y-axis. Okay? But in the case where we have a rotation on the x-axis and as well our function is the x-axis, we cannot apply shell methods. Therefore, if you apply shell method on this question, you won't get any answer. Okay? So let's move already from question 6.2. Then we change because the same function 6.2. But the good things about 6.2, they say now this function is rotating on the y-axis. Y-axis. Can you see that? So we take the same question, now it's rotating on the y-axis. So which means this is rotating now on the y-axis. Gonna have a look on question 6.2, which is basically similar to the question 6.1. But we could not solve 6.1, the reason, already you know the reason, okay? But now, with this question, which is 6.2, they say now the same function that we drew for 6.1, the same, it's still the same. But now, it's the rotation that changed. Now it's rotating to y-axis. So which means we have a body which is rotating to y-axis. And then we need to apply our shell method. And as I said, in order to apply our shell method, if our body is rotating on the y, I will expect a body to be revolved, our function to be revolved in the x-axis. Can you see that? And then you can see that in this case, it's rotating in y, but our body is revolved on this x-axis. So what is the formula now? The formula is going to be, it's going to be, the volume is going to be 2 pi x2 x1 xy ddx. This is the formula of the volume when this body is rotating on the y-axis using shell method. Can you see that? But if you are in the case where you have the function it rotating in the y-axis and then our function as well it revolves on the y function like this, you cannot apply your shell method. You need to apply this method. This method you can apply it with any question. Okay, so let's come here and see how to substitute. You can see that here we have 2 pi x2. Let's find our limit first. Already you can see that we have x is equal to 5. This is our first limit. Okay, but look here, they say y is equal to 0. So we're gonna check when y is equal to 0, what's gonna be the value of x. Can you see that? So when y is equal to 0, we're going to have 2x squared, and therefore our x is going to be equal to 0. Then this will be our second limit of x. So you come here now, you say that our bigger is going to be 5 and then 0, then you have x. Now look here, this is the function y. Where do we get it? Here. That should be our function. And then you come here, you say 2x squared ddx. And now we can do your integration. How do we integrate this? First of all, we say our volume will be given by pi 5 0, then you have 2 x cube. You can see cube ddx. And now you have 2 pi, which is the constant between the limit of what? 2. You can see what x, 3 plus 1, give us what? 4, divided by 4. Okay? So you can see that this will cancel that because, and that will cancel that. Okay? Then between the limit of 5 and 0. Okay? So if you take this here, we come with it here, we're going to find that our volume is going to be given by pi between the limit of x, 4 to the power of 0. Then you have pi of, let's say, 5 to the power of 4, okay, minus 0, okay, and then this will give us 625 pi. So that will be the solution to this. So as you can see, shell methods you'll see in your formula sheet, everything will be given to you, but as I said, it's all about if this body is rotating in the y-axis, okay, you're gonna expect a function, which means the body to be revolved here, so that you can apply your shell method. But if I in the case, because here we are still in the y-axis, rotation is the y-axis, okay. But now, if you are in the case when this body is rotating in the y-axis, and then the revolution is in the x-axis, you cannot apply shell method. You can apply shell method, but it's gonna be long. There is a formula that you have to apply there, but you ask me not go into it. You see that, you get the point. But even the same is applied for the y-axis. We mean with y-axis, if rotating in x-axis, which means we are here. If a body is rotating in x-axis, the body will be the revolve. This body will be revolved here. If it revolve here, it means you can have maybe something like this. It revolve here by rotating there. Then you can apply your shell method. Get a point? And then if now you have the same, it rotating in the x-axis, and now it revolve on the x-axis. Therefore, there is no way for you to apply shell methods. You can apply, but it's long. We are not going to it. But just not the following, not about the shell method. And then we're gonna do now a bit of our introduction now for the double integration, because there's nothing special about the double integration. So if you have a look on our double integration, double integral, okay? So it's all about, if you have this form, you can see that it's a double integral. So we can say dr, okay, for a specific body. What does that mean? We have an integration of 2 times, okay? We have to do the integral 2 times. You get the point? So we can see already that this r, it means we are in rectangular form. So when you're doing a double integration in a rectangular form, rectangular, okay? So it's all about a rectangular function. And then this r will be given by a and b, and then times c d, okay? So ab will be the limit of x, cd will be the limit of y, okay? And then what's the meaning of this ddr? Ddr, it simply mean ddx then ddy, okay? So when they give us something like this, what do? We come here, we change it to this form, okay? So you can see that we're gonna have a double integration of a specific function of ddx ddy. What are the limits of x? The limit of x is ABA, so you can see AB, okay? The limit of y, it's CD, then you have DC, okay? So how do you solve this problem? In order to solve a double integration, first of all, you start by the inner part. You do the integration of that part. Once you are done solving that part, now you can come and solve the last one, the outer part, okay? Integration according to x, the outer parts, then you get the integration according to Y. So we're gonna do an example so that we see what's gonna happen when we have to do our integration, double integration, okay? So let's say we go into our tutorial question, which is given to you, and already we're gonna have a look on question 7.1, okay? So they say calculate the volume under the plane of Z. They give us our function, which means our function is gonna be 6 minus X, Y minus Y, okay? And then they say over the rectangular region. Rectangular region, what does that mean? It means we're gonna have the volume of this body R dr, but here our function is what? It's Z. Our function is Z, okay? So what is the good information that they give us here? They give us that R is gonna be equal to what? Between 0 and that will be the limit of our X. So we know already the limit of our X, and then they give us as well the limit of our Y. Okay, so we have to calculate this, and as I said, we need to change this to this form, which means we know that it's gonna be this, it's gonna be DC, and then it's gonna be BA. And then we have our function Z is what is given by 6 minus X minus Y, okay, of d dx d dy, okay? What are the limits of X? We can see here it's given as between 3 and 0. So you change 3 and 0. What are the limits of Y? It's given as between 2 and 0. Then you come here, you say 2 and 0. So you start to integrate now, and as I said, you start with the inner part, and every time you're doing the integral according to X, anything here become the constant. You see, X 6 is a constant because it's not X. Y become a constant. An integration of a constant give us what? 6X, okay? An integration of our X, because we are doing integral according to X, so we're gonna have minus X squared over 2. Y, Y is what? It's a constant now. An integration of a constant give us what? X. Okay? And then between the limit of what? 3 and 0. That is our inner part. But our outer part is gonna be equal to 2, 0 and the integral of dy. Okay? And now you determine the limit of X, which means gonna be 6 between 3 minus 3 x squared over 2 minus y 3. Okay, already we have 0. Okay, and then we keep our outer part, it's gonna be d dy, and then the limits of 2 and 0. Okay, so after doing the calculation here, you're gonna end up having a function of the limits. We still have that 0 and that, but the inner part will give us 27 over 2 minus 3. Y, and then now we keep on the dy. So once you have done here, now you go into this outer part. Now can you see that? So that you can see that this is what is a constant. Integration of a constant give us what? But now it's according to what? Y. Then we have 27 over 2 y, okay, minus, here you have what? 3. We're gonna have 3. Y is gonna give us what? Y, 1 plus 1, 2 over 2, between the limit of what? 2 and 0. Then you determine the limit, it's gonna be 27 2 over 2 minus 3 2 squared over 2, and then our self final answer that we are going to get when you punch in your calculator is gonna be given by 21. So you see, that's how you do any type of double integration. You just go with it slowly. So in our next video, what we are going to do is we are going to discuss about the double integral of a non-rectangular volume, and then as well how to change the order of any function. And to change the order, it's all about, you come here, can you see that you have d dx? So to change the order, it's all about, you come here, you need to shift. We mean you start, this will be the first integral, and that will be the second integral. There is a way for you to change order, which means when you write our functions, it's gonna be something like this: double integral it's supposed to be ddx ddy. Now it's going to be ddy ddx. So we're going to have a look on how to change the order. Okay, and then I will try to upload a memo to some of the questions that you might solve under this double integration.